I played mobile games for half a day on S24 Exynos and S23 Snapdragon. At the end of the test, S23 compared to the S24 has 10% more battery. Mamma mia, how did that happen? To answer that, we should go through the test that I ran and talk about situations in which S24 started to lose the battle. Both phones are charged up to 100%. Whereas at the first test, which is playing Asphalt 9 and 5G, I will talk about testing conditions. You already know that I'm Mo, and I'm a scientist in real life, so I'm obligated to tell you the testing conditions in order for the experiment to be reproducible. The home temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, which is 77 degrees Fahrenheit. In some cases, both phones are connected to Wi-Fi, and some other cases to 5G, which I will always state. Both phones are 10 days old, and the batteries are already calibrated by going through multiple charging cycles. Both phones have the same brightness level. This test has 8 stages. I tested the game with Asphalt 9, Subway Surfers, PUBG Mobile, Genshin Impact, and Chess on browser. I also did a standby 5G test at the end. S23 has a slightly smaller battery capacity, but S24 has a slightly larger screen, so both of these factors are, in my opinion, negligible. S24 has a much larger vapor chamber, and it is 1.6 times bigger. A few minutes into the Asphalt 9 game, both phones are 60 frames per second and only reached 32 degrees Celsius for body temperature, which is 90 degrees Fahrenheit. That's very close to your skin temperature. To continue the Asphalt test, I put both phones into identical plastic cases. Also notice something interesting. The S24 is slightly taller than the S23, which means the S23 cases don't fit the S24. Towards the end of the test, both phones reached 35 degrees Celsius, which is 95 Fahrenheit. Both kept 60 frames per second easily. Asphalt 9 is not a heavy game, and it's written using a custom engine called Jet Engine. For you who know me, I used to be a game developer and also coded physics game engines. I'm impressed by how this studio smoothly implemented the engine instead of using Unreal or Unity. Respect. Even though on paper S24 used 1% more battery, I consider it negligible and a margin of error. So it is a draw so far, 1-1. I should quickly thank you all for 1000 subscribers. You folks are the best. Please subscribe if you haven't already to get the future updates. I let both phones cool down, and for the second test, I played PUBG Mobile 5G and maxed out the setting. PUBG games are often 20 minutes long. PUBG Mobile is written by Unreal Engine, and lots of famous shooter games are being written using this engine. Unreal traditionally is a PC game engine, but later, they also made an engine for mobile phones after they got better chipset. A few minutes into the test, S23 reached 40 degrees Celsius, which is 104 Fahrenheit, while S24 reached 43 degrees Celsius, which is 109 Fahrenheit. Both phones are holding 60 frames per second. In the middle of the test, things start to be very green for S24. It reached 47 degrees Celsius, which is 116 Fahrenheit, and the displays got dim. At first, I thought I accidentally dimmed the screen, but upon investigation, it seems like S24 overrides the manual brightness level when it hits. By the end of the test, there was a 7 degrees difference between the two phones, which is insane. The back of the S24 is 10 degrees hotter than the S23, which is again crazy. S24 used 3% more battery during the test. For me, it is a clear win for S23. Hence, the score is 2-1. Next, I moved to Genshin Impact on 5G and maxed out the setting. Genshin Impact is a heavy game written using Unity. When I was developing games using Unity, I never felt the engine was well suited for writing heavy mobile games using lots of shaders and stuff, but maybe that changed recently. I tried to do the same stuff on both phones to be fair, but I should add this test cannot be 100% accurate, since not every single fight scene is reproducible. 10 minutes into the test, both phones are around 40 degrees Celsius, which is 104 Fahrenheit. Still, neither showed a frame drop. Towards the end, S24 again dropped the ball. The battery temperature was 6 degrees higher and both phones dropped to 50 frames per second. S24 again dimmed the screen since it was overheating. The difference between the body temperature of the phones was not as big as last time. It was only 3 degrees Celsius in favor of S23. Now, S23 is at 66%, while S24 is 59%. I gave this round a clear win to S23. Now the score is 3-1 in favor of it. For the fifth test, I played Subway Surfers on 5G. On purpose, I did let the game run some advertisements in the background, especially because this process uses more 5G data. Subway Surfers is written using Unity. The problem with using widely available commercial game engine is that they are not always tailored to your needs, and it reduces the creativity of devs and designers when developing a game. They are also not as efficient. In this simple game, again, S23 had fewer thermal issues compared to S24. It was running 2 degrees less compared to S24. Both games held 120 frames per second throughout the whole game. Towards the end, the S24 had a 3 degrees higher battery and body temperature. Even though the battery usage was similar and now the difference is still 7%, due to bad thermals, I give S23 a clear win. Now it is 4-1 in favor of S23. You know, by this stage of the test, I started to develop a theory that the problem was the 5G connection. So I connected both phones to Wi-Fi to continue the test. For the sixth test, I ran PUBG Mobile on maxed out setting using Wi-Fi on both phones. You see, sending information on the internet is like sending letters. Imagine instead of sending a book, you send pages of the book separately by post. There is an overhead here, and the overhead is called the header information of those internet packages. Your phone should process those headers and the information in them one by one. A multiplayer game like PUBG Mobile needs to send a lot of packages for communication between players and servers. So if the chipset is not optimized for handling such a case, it is gonna heat and uses significantly more battery. Another thing to say is that on 5G, your phone is connected to multiple networks simultaneously, which is another battery drainer. Seems like S24 is not optimized well for it. It makes me think maybe that's the reason that Samsung didn't ship any flagship last year using Exynos, because they wanted to work on this problem. A few minutes into the game, they are both running on the same battery temperature and 60 frames per second. Also, I was lucky that I was matched with the same team on both phones, so I could move both characters together and the result wouldn't be biased. Towards then, S24 was 2 degrees higher than S23, but both had consistent 60 frames per second. I give this a draw since that 1-2 degrees could be a margin of error, hence the score is 5-2. It seems my theory was right and the problem is more 5G than pure gaming performance. For the next gaming test, I ran Genshin Impact on medium setting and Wi-Fi. Without going into details, again, both ones had a very similar performance. They both got to 40 degrees Celsius, which is 107 Fahrenheit, and the frame rate was very similar. I checked the chart of the frame rate in the Samsung Game Booster app later, and it seems the S24 did a slightly better and had 1-2 fewer dips compared to S24. Hence, I will give the first win to S24. Let me know in the comment section if there is an app that I can use to compare the performance of games even better. I give this round to S24 to celebrate its first win. The result is now 5-3. For the last gaming test, I played chess on Wi-Fi using Google Chrome. And please don't judge how I play, it was really difficult playing two games simultaneously. Both ones used 2% battery, so the result is another draw. Even though S24 was closing the gap on Wi-Fi test, the final gaming performance score was still in favor of S23, and the final result was 6-4. Lots of you ask, but Mo, what about the standby 5G battery test? To answer your question, I left both phones in the bathroom without a good 5G connection for over 24 hours. By the end of the test, both phones lost the same amount of battery and the difference is still 8%. I'm not going to empty the battery of the phones like last time, it is kind of abusing. This process is very damaging to new lithium batteries. Never let your phone go below 10%. For the best longevity of the phone battery, always keep it between 15 to 90% battery life. It is always better to top off your battery instead of letting it go into a full cycle from 0 to 100%. My verdict is that on Wi-Fi, both phones are very similar in performance, thermals, and battery. My limited tests show that both Unity and Unreal Engine games don't run well on 5G for S24. My theory is that it is due to 5G process of data on Exynos 2400 compared to S23, the Snapdragon 8th generation 2. So if you're at the end of the trilogy of comparison of S23 Snapdragons to the S24 Exynos, I'm going to move to S24 Snapdragon versus S24 Exynos next. My final thought is that Samsung outdone itself last year. The S23 is so good that even a new generation of Exynos cannot compare with it, at least in gaming. The result for camera performance and daily battery life was also interesting. Check out those videos that I published and popping up right now. Thanks for tuning in to Techmo. Until the next comparison, bye!